Hello. Man, it is so cold outside. It's almost summertime. It basically is summertime. It's just cold, like it's late fall or late winter out there. People sometimes say I flap my lips too much and I don't get to the point. And or not so much love due to maybe possible excessive repetition. I'll actually tell you in a nutshell the most fundamental, simple misunderstanding of humanity. And by the way, quantum, not my words, their words. By their own admission, their own words, I heed you, their own words, is that quantum is based upon their understanding of the nature of light. And before actually explaining this in very simplex, and this video is going to be quite short, is that I have at no point in time ever denied atoms. I have, however, ragged on atomism, which is a belief system. Specifically, it's actually a religion. The refutation and attacking of atomism is completely different than talking about atoms. Atomism is a belief that the entire universe is bumping particles and that, fields are virtual photons, and this is the position of... and of course, these are fairy tales. It's like talking about angels and demons, something that no one's ever seen. It's a completely arbitrary, fanciful, fantasy concept. So my refutation of atomism has nothing to do, and I at no point in time ever denied atoms exist. I have specifically, however, stated, parroting that of Nikola Tesla, Oliver Heaviside, Dollard, and others, said that there's no such thing as a charge-carrying particle, i.e. an electron. And there is not. It's a completely arbitrary concept. But in a nutshell, to understand the fundamental misapprehension of humanity so far as physics, and specifically to attacking quantum, and their cult of physicalism or atomism, and of course atomism dates back to the ancient Greeks and probably way before then, is a screwed up belief system. And of course beliefs, is an interchangeable term with faith and religion. And I have nothing against someone's faith, but religion, of course, is secularized metaphysics. It is a belief system. And their apprehension of the nature of the universe is based upon their understanding of what light is. Light, and people all the time ask me about the dual slit experiment and the wave-particle duality, and let's actually talk about those two very, very briefly because it's going to be a short video. A duality is an inherent paradox, and Mother Nature doesn't deal in paradoxes. Paradoxes and nature are two wholly different things, like oil and water. They don't mix at all. The dual slit experiment presupposes, I'm going to quote Einstein for you, the insane lunatic Einstein, the guy that Nikola Tesla called a fuzzy-haired crackpot. And by the way, the gentle soul that Nikola Tesla was, the only time Nikola Tesla lost his cool and foamed at the mouth, not literally, but kind of foamed at the mouth, was attacking the notion that space had properties. And of course, you have to do this if you're an atomist, because there's only ever been two foundations of the universe, cosmic mechanics, ever postulated by any human throughout all history. One's based on the ether, the other one's based upon bumping particles, particle interaction. Let me quote to you, and this is not a super, super accurate quote, but it's 99% accurate. This is what Einstein said. You know, the definition, I'm going to say it like a German-English accent here, it would be Albert Einstein. You know, when speaking of light, the light was, at one time it behaves like a wave. And a wave is not a thing, by the way. Sometimes light behaves like a wave, and sometimes it behaves like a particle. Neither one of them accurately describes light, but together they do. And then they came up with this wave-particle duality of light. And this is the position, not my position, this is the position of quantum. Number one, Mother Nature doesn't deal in dualities, because a duality in Mother Nature cannot be enjoined. It's like talking about unicorn farts and leprechaun gold. It's fantasy. Doesn't exist. A wave is not a thing. And light is definitely not a particle. The misapprehension of the so-called particle or photon of light, which is purely conceptual, has no basis in reality whatsoever, is the misapprehension of the observed phenomena of light, wherein which the longitudinal propagation of light at X frequency and X wavelength rarefacts and compresses. I don't know if you know what rarefaction or compression would be. Like, this would be rarefaction, where there's basically almost nothing there. And this, of course, would be compression. Now, if you were to look at this, and it's going, of course, the propagation is the speed of light, and light's not a speed, it's a rate of propagation. But if I were to do this at an X frequency, an X wavelength, well, here we have a particle. Here we have just like a string of particles, like pearls on a necklace. So the misapprehension of light is, and light, of course, is a coaxial circuit, transverse electrical magnetic, and these, of course, are manifestations due to the pulse perturbation of light at X frequency. And also, too, something very, very important that nobody gets, even Eric Dollard doesn't get this. He has said specifically, however, and he's accurate, and he got this from Charles Proteus Steinmetz, a genius of electrical theory, is the smaller the space, the higher the capacitance. Contrary to human apprehension, you know, the larger boxes, the more it could hold. In field theory, the smaller the space, the higher the capacitance. This is the reason why gamma radiation, the most dangerous radiation, is just light. This is not my position, this is a fact. Gamma radiation is nothing other than super high energy light. Fact. The volume, let's just say this is the volume of visible light, right? This is the volume in the transverse electrical magnetic. Well, the volume of gamma radiation, which is infinite, countless multiplicatives, more dangerous than UV or microwave. The volume of gamma, instead of visible light here, is so small I couldn't even show it to you on the tip of a pinpoint or tip of a needle. So the volume is incredibly small, but the power is incredibly large. Gamma radiation actually acts like even though it's light, acts like a bullet, really. It should be called quasi-matter when you actually come to that small of a capacitance. I mean, that high of a capacitance and that small of a volume. The radiation that is gamma acts literally like a particle. Like it's a particle emission. I'm trying to think of the smallest particle emission. Someone actually found a way to super accelerate helium nuclei. Alpha radiation, that's a matter for another thing. Sorry, I kind of got off on a divergent topic there, but this video is supposed to be short. The point is that their apprehension of light is completely arbitrary, conceptual, and fantastical. It's not true. Now, we all know about the speed of sound. I grew up, and same as you, grew up talking, being taught nonsense, of course, about the speed of sound. We know the speed of sound is blah, 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 blah. Okay, that's great. Breaking the sound barrier, Mach 1, breaking the sound. Well, sound doesn't have a speed. Nothing emits sound. When I speak, I'm not emitting anything. I'm actually setting up a perturbation in the medium that is the air. Obviously, that's the nitrogen and oxygen that's being perturbed and propagating. Okay, that's the maximum rate of propagation, the speed of sound. By the way, the speed of sound changes whether the air is super hot or super cold or whether it's humid. Same too with light. Like when you pass light through glass, it slows down significantly. Not super significantly, but it slows down a lot. It's still insanely fast. But it's not traveling. All the misapprehensions of these idiots of quantum, and all of quantum, by their own admission, is based upon their understanding of light. Light is not an emission. Light doesn't travel from point A to point B. By the way, Walter Russell said the same stuff. So did Nikola Tesla. I have a quote, I've talked about it endlessly. Light is not an emission, it doesn't travel from point A to point B. It doesn't have a speed, the so-called speed is rate of propagation. If you ever really want to piss off a PhD, a professor of theoretical physics, is ask him how light speeds back up after it leaves glass or water without breaking the law of conservation of energy. All of these misunderstandings about these riddles, it's like, how do you explain the wave-particle duality? And I'll tell them flat out. So when you talk about the wave-particle, the dual-slit experiment, first we actually have to start from the beginning, because the dual-slit experiment starts with a supposition that light is a wave, or light that is a particle, or light's an emission, or light that's traveling, or light has a speed. It starts out with countless false, 100% false suppositions about the nature of light, and then the experiment's conducted. If you start out with a false supposition about the nature of the phenomena that you're testing, then not only is the experiment completely ludicrous, but also too the conclusions from that experiment are additionally so ludicrous. Light is not an emission. It doesn't travel. Sure it does. No, light doesn't. The only way, literally, and I guarantee you, no matter what the hell you think of me, I know of more phenomena and anomalies of light than you do, and even to your professor.
I have a PhD in physics.
Even more than him, more phenomena of light. And the only way that you can explain all the observed phenomena and strangeness of light, you know, every little weird experiment done with or by light, is the accurate, logical way that I'm speaking of. It's not an emission. It doesn't travel. It's not a particle. It's not a wave. It's not a wave-particle duality. It doesn't have a speed. Just like sound is not an emission. Sound doesn't travel from point A to point B. Sure, it does. It's got speed. It's like, that's not a speed. That's a rate of propagation. I'm not emitting anything when sound is generated. What I'm doing is causing a vibration at X frequency. Yeah? At X frequency in the air. Nitrogen and oxygen. Light is no different than sound. I mean, don't take the analogy too far now, okay? But light is no different. The medium, instead of the nitrogen and oxygen, is, of course, the ether. Yes, the ether. You could never explain light as this particle wave or wave particle duality nonsense with a speed, light is emitted, this photon nonsense. A photon is an arbitrary, and I have the original articles of where these idiots came up with the idea of a photon. It is literally, not my opinion, it is literally an arbitrary conceptual construction.
Well, we see that light is going to manifest in these bundleless, well, that's a photon.
That's literally how they came in. And since you're an atomist, if you're a hammer, then everything is a nail, right? Well, all of these physicists, which are atomists, they think everything is a particle. They have no idea in their bleeping head what the hell a field is. They've never defined a field. I'll tell you what a field is, by the way. A field is an ether perturbation modality. Just like ice, water, and steam are temperature and pressure modalities of water, right? Mother Nature's fields are already unified. Human beings are so stupid. Fundamentally, there's only two fields, magnetism and dielectricity. Electricity is a hybrid of both. Phi times psi equals Q and Planck of electrification. Gravity is a misappropriation of what it is. Of course, gravity is not a force, it's an acceleration, but specifically it's non-point source mutual mass acceleration. Magnetism, so-called magnetic attraction, which does not exist, it's not magnetism at all, because magnetism is specifically force and motion, specifically it's a divergent field modality, specifically too, further still, the dielectric field manifestation, the loss of that energy or inertia, which manifests as a force vector, an expanding loop, and collectively, of course, it forms a torus. That's the conjugate geometry of the universe, the hyperboloid and the torus, which are the negative images of one another, the negative image of an hourglass. A hyperboloid is a torus, and a negative image of torus is a hyperboloid, but that's going too far down the rabbit hole. I'm actually keeping things simple, and yet people still think I'm making things complicated. This video is supposed to be short. The point is, the point is that these people are insane. All of their ideas are built upon a foundation that's made out of poppycock and twaddle. Literally all of quantum, by their own definition, is built upon
our understanding of what light is.
Well, really? Well, everything they understand about light is completely ridiculous. It's ludicrous. It's nonsensical. It paints Mother Nature as a crazy, cross-eyed lunatic. She's actually worse than that. Mother Nature is a hairy armpit chick with a hemp skirt and muddy feet. There are no dualities in Mother Nature or natura naturans. In true cosmic mechanics, it's completely impossible. If aliens landed and knew that we're spouting this crap as truth to the world, they'd be like, man, these people are monkeys. They're like hairless monkeys. And they'd leave. Human beings don't understand what light is. You and I were talk crap and nonsense, which is completely inconsistent, illogical, hyperbolic twaddle. A photon is an arbitrary concept with no basis in reality. And all of quantum is built upon a lie, which is their fantastical model something akin to Harry Potter, their fantastical model of what light is. And they don't know what it is. Light is nothing other than a coaxial circuit. It's a longitudinal pulse perturbation with corresponding, whether it be circular linear polarizations of electrical magnetic. It's divinely simplex, but a wave is not a thing. Light is not a wave, and it's certainly not a particle, and it's not a wave-particle duality because there are no dualities in nature. Light is not an emission. It doesn't move from point A to point B, and it doesn't have a speed. All of these false suppositions are pre-assumed before experiments with light are done by these idiot physicists. And then they make conclusions based upon false observations with faulty presuppositions about the medium that they're actually testing. This was meant to be a short video. I'm so sorry it didn't turn out to be short, but at least it was succinct. At least I hope. At least I believe it was. I hope you like these videos. If you want me to discuss this topic further, let me know. If you like the videos, so you know, it's click the link below. Let me know what you think. Send me an email. I get lots of emails. Every day I wake up, there's like 100, 150 emails. Thank you so much. Lux e veritas. Thank you.